A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd September, on the front page you have Modi Trump set new course on terrorism border security. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi defended action on Article 370 at the massive joint rally in Houston, which was called Howdy Modi Meet in Houston and Texas, where US President Donald Trump was also present. It was a meet of around 50,000 Indian Americans. So you can see there was an attack on Pakistan evident. It was a veiled attack, a scarcely veiled attack on Pakistan. Mr. Modi said the whole world knows where the threats from 9/11 terror attacks to 26/11 Mumbai attacks lead. So this is there, and the two countries have said border security is vital, and about it, it was said that unprecedented action has been taken on US, will be taken on US southern borders. Then this is Kashmir Valley's IT hub gasps as net shutdown continues. So this is regarding the future of IT sector workers in Kashmir Valley. So the prolonged internet shutdown is a cause of concern here. You can see there are around 22,000 persons who are employed in around 500 IT firms there, and around 1,200 work in 7 companies in the industrial complex at Rangareth in Budgam district. So internet connection was never suspended in the IT hub even during the agitation and unrest in 2008, 2010 and 2016. But presently, Department of Telecom has strict security compliance norms for IT companies. They have to maintain a logbook of all URLs visited by them and their clients for 6 months. Then on page 6 you have NRC excluded Gurkhas in Assam to shun tribunals. So government has no right to try Indians in such tribunals meant for foreigners is what these NRC excluded Gurkhas of Assam say. They say this is an attempt of a few vested interests within the system to disrespect Indian Gurkhas. On page 8 you have Telangana inflating surplus. So Comptroller and Auditor General of India CAG has conducted audit here, and it has found that in Telangana revenue surplus has been overstated and fiscal deficit understated. So this is the audit report detailed out. And here you have endosulfan victims send notice to Kerala. So this is regarding endosulfan, which is a pesticide which has been historically been sprayed on cashew plants. The cashew plantations of Kerala state government itself had it air sprayed, which has affected the adjoining villages, and it has resulted in severe deformities among children especially and in the population, which has been linked to endosulfan, and that is where compensation has to be paid. And Supreme Court has ordered a relief of 5 lakh each for endosulfan victims, but Kerala government has still not honored it. So this is regarding that. On the editorial page, the first editorial is local matters. So this is regarding elections in Maharashtra and Haryana. So the announcement of assembly elections as such will result in further again campaigning for them. So this editorial says that issues of livelihood governance should shape poll campaigns in Maharashtra and Haryana. Then second is seeking to secure. So this is regarding linking Aadhaar with GST registration. So the editorial says this move is a tentative step in the right direction. The lead article, the nationalist hindrance to climate actions. So this is regarding the UN climate action summit which is going to take place, and says it is likely to hand out hard lessons about climate politics in an era of nationalism. So every nation tries to have its own interests secured, which is a very difficult time for climate action. So, climate politics as it is called is detailed out here. And this is Punjab's pain, India's agony, Britain's unrepentance. So, this is regarding Jallianwala Bagh massacre. And this article says that UK needs to build on the Archbishop of Canterbury's repentance gesture at Jallianwala Bagh. So, UK also needs to apologize. Then on the op-ed page you have, when the pedestal feels like a cage. So this is regarding how there's a need to make public spaces more accessible to the disabled. So this is there. And this is the importance of labeling hate crimes. So how hate crimes impact the social fabric of the country is detailed out here. and this is India's opportunity at the UN. So this is regarding how Modi government has a chance to regain its footing in the court of international public opinion. So this is regarding the UN General Assembly. Prime Minister Narendra Modi would address it on September 27. On page 12 you have Suriname backs India's decision on Jammu and Kashmir. So Suriname Vice President had talks, as said that we favor talks between India and Pakistan to resolve tension, and they back India's decision on revoking Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir. Then this is Delhi-Dhaka to boost maritime ties. So this is regarding the historic voyage of Mukti Jodha. So plan is to retrace that historic voyage. This is regarding how Delhi-Dhaka historically have had strong ties, that is India and Bangladesh. So they'll boost their maritime ties now. Then on page 13 you have, ahead of Howdy Modi, India struck big ticket LNG deal. So updating an MOU signed in February, Petronet will now invest $2.5 billion in Tellurian Inc., giving India access to up to 5 million tons of gas per year. Then on international page, it is continuation of the old news, so there is no new news here. Even business page on Monday has this money wise coverage, which is not relevant. And the last page also has sports news. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.